Hello, my friends, and welcome back to PlayStation Live from E3. We resume. We are going to be looking at Neo 2, and joining me on stage, some of the folks from Team Ninja. We have Yasuda-san, we have Lee-san, and another Lee-san, Tom Lee-san. Gentlemen, welcome to the program. It's good to have everyone here, and Justin, it's good as always to have
you along. I'm also here.
So let me start at the top. I want to know, Yasuda-san, what your goal was when creating Neo 2. And did the team have a particular philosophy in their work?
Hi, 今回の Neo 2に関する目標は何だと思っていますか? そしてチームが開発における哲学のようなものは持っていますか?
ちょうど昨日 Neo 2発表させていただいたんですけど、今回はですね、正しく進化させるっていうのを一つのテーマにしてます。前作非常にいい評価いただいたんですけど、やっぱり私たち しっかりできなかった分もいっぱいあったので、今回そういったものをしっかりですね、いいとこは正しく伸ばして、悪いとこはしっかり潰していくっていう形で、続編ではありますけど、新作のような気持ちで新しいものを今作ろうと思ってます。
So my goal for this Neo 2 would be a proper evolution, a natural evolution, not dramatic change, not obviously deteriorate, but because in the first title, although we're very happy with how it was received, but there were things that we couldn't accomplish at the same time. So I'd like to, strengthen what we did well, at the same time, fix some of the issues that couldn't be done in time. So yeah, that's what I'd like to see happen in the Neo 2.
What are some of the lessons that the team learned during the development of the first game that you're keeping in mind while developing Neo 2?
その、出演作で得た教訓で、今回活かしたいものについてちょっとお聞かせいただけますか。そうですね。チームNinjaもともとNinjaガイデンをずっと作っていたので、アクションゲームの経験あったんですけど、日本はアクションRPGなので、やっぱりキャラクターの成長だったり、そういったところのバランシングですよね。RPG部分のバランスを取るのが、すごく初経験だったこともあって、すごくアップデートの時に、やっぱりお客さんに非常に良くない アップデートをかけてしまったりとか、そういったことあったので、2ではそういうことないように、しっかり計画して、ゲーム作っていきたいなと思ってます。So,
okay, Team Ninja, we're known for creating action games, but Neo, on the other hand, was first action RPG that we'd ever dealt with. So, I'd say in some of the game balancing and in the RPG department, and some of the game updates had certain issues that players might not necessarily be happy with, so that's something I'd like to improve on, and we'll do better this time.
Okay.
Before we get to another question, I think we can maybe run some footage of the game on our big screen here for our audience as I get to our next question. And I'm curious to know how, Yasuda-san, the story of Neo 2 fits into the existing story and the larger character development that your team has done so far.
今回のストーリーは前作とどういう絡みがあるんでしょうか?
そうですね、絡みはあるんですけど、時代だったりキャラクターだったりっていうのはまた今後少しずつこう皆さんにお伝えしていきたいなとは思います。ただ1作目遊んでなくても2作目は楽しめますし、1作目遊んでたらより楽しめるものにしたいなと思ってて、ちょうどちょっと宣伝になっちゃうんですけど、今ネオワンセール中なので、ぜひプレイしていただけたらなと思います。
Okay, so yes, it ties in with the first story. How time and setting, those will reveal in the coming days. But to me, I feel that people who's never played Neo 1 could enjoy the story, but it will be even more so for people who didn't, for people who actually played the first game. This is just sales talk, but Neo, right now, is on sale, so we'd like to invite people who's never tried the game to give it a try.
Yeah. Nice plug, good
Perfect
call.
Perfect plug. Justin, take the next one.
Yeah. Did the way that players reacted to the first game influence the team when creating Neo 2?
Can you repeat that question again?
Did the way that players reacted to the first game influence the way that the team approached Neo 2?
ユーザーの1作目に対するフィードバックが今回活かせるところはどういうところでしょうか?
そうですね、やっぱり前回もあの体験版を数回やってプレイヤーのフィードバックいただきながら改善していったんですけど、今回はあの新しくナンバリング2ということなんで、まあ、結構意見多くいただいてたあの主人公のキャラクタークリエイトに対応しようと思ってます。
Okay, so we did two demos before the first, the first Neo was launched, and you know, we're truly grateful for all the feedback that we received from our fans. Now, having said that, after the game was launched, one of the biggest requests that we had was to have the character creation, and that's something we're going to implement in the second one.
Oh, cool.
あの人種だったり性別だったりもいろんな姿でプレイできるようにしようかなと。
So players will definitely be able to customize all the details, including like gender and race.
Oh, that's awesome.
Excellent. Another thing that I'm curious about is, what do you think makes this series or makes this game unique and sets it apart from other, you know, third-person action-oriented games?
他のアクションゲームと比べて、ニオのユニークなところはどういったところでしょうか？
やっぱり一番特徴的なのは、近接の格闘コンバットかなと思っていて、あの刀とか、まあ、そういった日本特有の武器でそれぞれこう構えがあったりとか、あとあの斬新っていうアクションもあって、そういった部分がやっぱ元も特徴的かなと、まあ、あとはそのプレイヤーと敵キャラクターの気力の駆け引きみたいなところもシステムとして最もこう特徴があると思ってますね。
In general, I think it's the close quarter combat system. We have some very Japanese, we have certain elements that are very uniquely Japanese style, such as, say, the ki pulse and the sword, the stances of the weapons. In addition to that, maybe, you know, the fact that both the player and the enemy have the stamina bar, that's probably something unique to, yeah, unique to Neo.
Excellent.Justin, you want to take the last one?
ちょっと補足すると、すいません。まあ、あの今回主人公が侍ではあるんですけど、今ちょうどティザー映像流れてますけど、あの妖怪の力も持ってるという設定があって、なので、まあ、侍対侍ってまでこれまで描いてきましたけど、妖怪対妖怪だったり、妖怪対侍っていうシチュエーションも増えるので、そのコンバットの部分でさらに、まあ、次元が一つ増やせるかなと、トワイライト2では、そこを目指して、ニオ2では今目指してやってます。
And just to supplement, as we're all watching the teaser trailer, you know, players can probably tell that the next protagonist actually possesses the power of yokai. So as seen in before, you know, samurai versus yokai, samurai versus samurai. This time around, we're going to have yokai versus samurai and yokai versus yokai as well. So.You'll be able to feel some of the yokai skills and the yokai moves. This should bring the action system to the next level.
Okay. Last question. What do you think is the most important thing that the team needs to get right with Neo
2? 今回の作品においてチームにとって何を最もあの正しくやることが大事というふうに考えておられますか？
今回ニオ2ではやっぱりそのただまあ簡単にしたりしてもしょうがないので、うん、やっぱちゃんと手応え歯応えがある状態でただその気持ちよく死んでもらうっていうのを一番大切にしてます、ね。
First of all, you know, as a mass core game, we'll make it satisfying again. But in that, I'd like to make it more. If this sounds weird, if we wanted to have more satisfying deaths for players.
Awesome. やっぱりその私たちだけがそれをやっても難しいので、まあ、バランス取っていきたいなと思っていて当然チーム忍者が思うベストなものは作りつつですけどまたあの今回も体験版を配信しようと思っているので、うん、それはぜひプレイしていただいて客観的な意見も取り入れながら、まあ、ニオ2をより、まあ、最高のものにしていきたいなと今考えてます。
While Team Ninja will do its best, you know, bringing everybody the best product, but we don't want it to be just our, you know, subjective opinion. So as we did in Neo, we'd bring everybody the free demo again to get your feedback and make this game right.
Oh, well, there you go.
Tom, we haven't heard from you at all, and I was just wondering if you want to give a message to all the Neo fans the world over before we let you go?
Sure. You know, first of all, we want to thank everybody for making Neo a success. And having said that, I think just to kind of draw a comparison of where we were and where we're at, I think, you know, with Neo, it was our first time, you know, getting into that genre. And to be quite honest, you know, as part of our team, we were a little bit cautious, and it was sort of trepidatious in that sense. And I think this time around, with the experience that we've gained, and obviously all the encouragement and the support we have, we've gained a lot of confidence as well. And thinking back, there were a lot of things that we didn't get to do. But this time around, I guess the simple way for me to put this is, you know, the gloves are off. Like, we're going to go in hard. And so I hope the fans are ready for it, because I think this experience is going to be, you know, close to what we really had in mind. So I can't wait for you guys to play it.
Thank you, gentlemen, so much for being here.
Thank you.
And thank you, everyone, for watching at home. That was a look at Neo 2 and hearing from the Team Ninja crew, and it's so nice to have them here. And it's also nice that we're about to see more of Anthem from BioWare in just a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. Stay with us. PlayStation.